Welcome back to another Row Hunting Resources instructional video series. You know, if you're anything like me, by the time that winter starts winding down, my mind's shifting over and I'm getting geared up for turkey season. Now, I give literally dozens of turkey seminars throughout Colorado and the West each year, and I talk to hundreds of hunters. And there's one general type of question that I always get, and it doesn't matter if I'm talking to, you know, beginning hunters or veteran turkey hunters, and that is, how do I use a certain type of call, either, you know, how do I learn to use a box call, or how do I learn to use a slate call, or how can I learn to use this call better? And so that's what this series is going to talk about. We're going to dive into all the different types of turkey calls that are available to you on the market today, and what you can, you know, how you can use them in the field. Not only are we going to talk about how to learn how to use them, but we're going to talk about the materials that they're made out of, so you can understand, you know, the pluses and minuses, you know, whether they give you a more raspy sound or a higher quality, or a clearer sound, a high frequency sound or a low pitch sound, whether they're waterproof or whether they're not. We're going to talk about the advantages of using some of those calls in your hunts. We're also going to talk about some of the disadvantages of using some of these calls, or maybe even just the limitations of them. We're going to talk about box calls. We're going to talk about pot style calls, or some people just call them pot and peg style calls, or, you know, just generically speaking, slate calls. We're going to talk about mouth calls. We're going to talk about locator calls, and we're going to talk about specialty calls. So we're going to pick them all apart, and hopefully by the time you get through this, again, if you're a beginner, you'll have a full understanding of what these calls are, what they do, how to use them, so that when you go to the sporting goods shop and you want to go purchase one, you'll know what you're looking for, and you'll know how to use it, and you'll know how to kind of listen to it and evaluate it when you're there at the shop before you buy it, so you're making an educated purchase, so you know what you're going to be doing or what you're going to be using when you go in the field. For you veteran hunters, maybe some of you have not tried a pot-style call, or maybe some of you don't even have a box call. By the time we're done with this, hopefully you'll see that maybe you might want to add a different type of call to your arsenal, or maybe you'll learn that you just need to use it slightly different to get a better quality sound out of it and be a little bit more effective. Again, the purpose here is to help you understand these calls so that when you get in the field, you know what you're doing and be more effective in any of your hunting efforts.